page number 82, second paragraph. He gives an introduction to Brahmananda Valli. So the first paragraph is the meaning of Sahana Bhavatu, which we have already seen. Based upon this Bhashya alone, we saw this. We will start with the introduction. Samhitadi Vishayani Karma Bihi Aviruddhani Upasanani Yuktani. Not read, huh? Samhitadi Vishayani Karma Bihi Aviruddhani Upasanani Uktani. So Bhashyakara is now presenting a connection. It's called a Sambandha. A Sambandha between the first chapter and the second chapter. Earlier in the introduction also, it is called Sambandha Bhashya, which is a connection between the Veda Purva Bhaha and the Anta Bhaha. The first portion of the Veda and the last portion of the Veda, he gave a connection. Now, having said the first chapter, why should you need the second chapter? First chapter is all done. So, Bhashyakara, being a commentator, he should write why you should study the second chapter. You made me struggle hard to study the whole of the first chapter for 3 months or 4 months, and then you are starting a second chapter for what? That is called Sambandha. You need to connect. What is the connection? That he says here, Samhitadi Vishayani Karma Bihi Aviruddhani Upasanani Uktani. So, in the previous chapter, various forms of meditations with reference to Samhita, with reference to Sandhi, they were all discussed. So, when you have two vowels coming together, it forms a certain form, it takes another form. It is called a Sandhi, joining. It joins to put, in Sanskrit, it joins to form another form, it takes a letter. Let A plus U becomes O. That is because of Sandhi. And like this, there are various forms of Sandhi. And there is Samhita. Anything that is in close proximity is called as Samhita. So in the first chapter, certain upasanas, certain meditations are all dealt with regard to these sandhis, with regard to upasanas, with regard to the samhita. That is what he says. Samhitadi vishayani karma bihi. Various ideas were superimposed on the locus of sandhi and meditated upon. Like upon a national flag, you invoke a country. Similarly, upon these sandhis, on the locus of the sandhis, various ideas are superimposed. We will see that. We all saw that in the first chapter of the Taittirīya Upanishad, which I am not doing it here. That is being mentioned by Bhashyakara. All of them are what? They are all karma bihi aviruddhani. Those meditations that were talked about, they are not opposed to karma. That means they do not have the power to eliminate samsara from you. That is what you saw in Rama Gita as well today. So Bhashyakara says, when I say Bhashyakara, it is Shankaracharya here. Some people have got Ramanuja also as a Bhashya. We are reading Shankara Bhashya here. Shankaracharya, it's a respect. We don't call names of the gurus, names of the sampradaya, we don't tell names. We only say Bhashyakara, Vrittikara, Vartikakara, Tikakara. The students who are here, according to the text, according to the context, they understand who is the Bhashya here. The Bhashya is Shankara. Bhashyakara means Shankaracharya. So what does he say here? These karmas are not opposed. The meditations that you took to, they are also what? Manasam karma. Therefore, they are not going to remove these mental actions, they are not going to remove ignorance away from you. They are not going to take you out of samsara. Because whenever you say it is karma, a karma is all the time dependent upon a karaka. Kartratantram karma. It is dependent upon a karaka. Like subject. When you say, I am doing an action, you will ask the question, who does the action? Correct? That is called kartrikaraka. The subject. And then there is karma, object of an action. Goes, who went? Rama goes, or Rama went. Rama went where? Rama went to the forest. Along with whom? Third karaka. Along with someone he went, along with Sita. So in Sanskrit, all these things, these accessories which are centered upon an action, is called karaka. A doer. Whenever you do an action, that doer is there, correct? The sense of doership. Every manasam karma has got this sense of doership. There is a dependence upon the subject. The dependence upon the subject, because they are all Purusha Tantram, centered upon, that is why they are all centered upon your free will. You can do an action. You need not do an action, you can do it differently. Every karma is centered upon the Purusha, the will of the person. There is free will involved in it. There are other things which are Vastu Tantram, based upon the object. It is all dependent upon the object. Like when you say, this is ever silver. When you say ever silver, what kind of free will do you have there? It is not Purusha Tantra, it is Vastu Tantram, because the object happens to be a silver or ever silver vessel. You don't take an ever silver to be silver, correct? You don't take. Ever silver is never silver, Swamiji says. You know that. So the Vastu does not depend upon your wish. It proves itself through a pramana called the eyes. Whether it is ever silver or it is not a silver, it is a silver iti, your eyes determine, it depends upon a pramana. So the threefold karma, physical actions, mental actions, as well as oral actions, kayika, manasa, vachika karmas, they are all what? Purusha tantram eva. Centered upon the person. So the difference between action, karma, and jnanam, knowledge, has got to be properly understood. Modern Vedantins do not know this difference. Without understanding certain basic things, if one studies Vedanta, then it is not Vedanta, it is Devanta. Therefore, Bhashyakara here says, karma bihi aviruddhani upasanani uktani. He just makes a statement and he proceeds. He doesn't talk about the implications. The upasanas are not opposed to karma. Upasanas means meditations. They are not opposed to karma. That means when they are not opposed to karma, they are karma only. They only add, they only propagate. And therefore what? The first chapter that is dealt is not going to, they are not opposed, being not opposed to karma. I told you yesterday, where there is karma, there is going to be karma phala involved, because there is a subject. A karta is involved. A doer of the action is involved. Whenever you say, I am the doer of an action, the doer indicates what? If you do a legitimate action, there is going to be punyam. Illegitimate action produces papam. Don't say, Swamiji, I am doing only Punya Karma. Punya is equally a culprit as good as Papa in bringing you back. Correct? Is it not nice, Swamiji, to be in a very good environment with a good family? Why do you say no? He say no because there is old age. Dukkha is there. You cannot avoid it. And there is no punya which is 100% punya, understand? Correct? No punya is 100% punya. Punya is always mixed with it. It's an amalgamation of papa also. Little bit of papa. Kuch na kuch. So you are just putting some samit. You are doing some havan. And then you want to put some samit and you are doing some havan. You are doing a homa. Somaya swaha. Somaya yidanna mama. You put some samit into it. And when you are putting this samit, samit is just the twig. The twig of a banyan tree or a twig of the peepal tree. It's called a samit. So you put that. When you are putting that in the heaven, while you are dropping it, there can be what? Some insect which you have not taken sight of. So somaya swaha is producing punya. The insect that you drop in into the fire, what happens to that? Papa, amalgamation. Understand? Amalgamation. Nothing is 100%. Like these people tell you what? Pure gold. Pure gold means what? 98% or 99%. 1% something is mixed. It's an alloy. Similarly, every time karma is only an alloy of punya and papa. So where is the question of you enjoying only punya in your life? It's not going to happen at all. Therefore, this karma, whether it is mental action or a physical action. No, Swamiji, I have taken sight of it. Everything is okay. But you think, sometimes our thinking has got some gadabud. Khatam. The most difficult thing is to do a karma, you know. Because after the karma, they say, how many lopas? Mantra lope, uccharana lopa is there. The fellow cannot produce vakara, he will produce bakara or vakara. Finish. So Panini Maharishi writes a sutra of Abhayor Abhedaha. People from Bengal, they don't know, they can't produce, not everybody, most of them. Way of Bengal, they'll say way of Bengal. Correct? Vabayor Abhedaha, Vakara and Bakara has no difference. Then some Orissa people also, they do this. Varanda, they will not say Baranda. That happens in Sanskrit also. When Vakara comes, Bhakara. I don't know how that flip comes. Japanese is Ra will not come. Ask them to pronounce this Ra. La. So, Mantra Lopa. You have done an omission now. What Akshara has got to be produced, you have produced another Akshara. Then Mantra Lope, Tantra Lope, Kriya Lope. All these are okay. Kriya means action. I have done everything rightly. Shraddha lope. Kuch na kuch you doubt. You know, I am doing this action. I don't know if it will give or not, but I trust you, God. Shraddha lope. Kala lopa. You have to do it at 5 o'clock. Ganapati Oma should be done before sunrise. This fellow starts Ganapati Oma only after sunrise and goes up to lunch. Kala lope. If nothing happens, naivedyani nihita lopecha. So many lopas are there, omissions, which is possible. In the process of karma, producing what? Papam. You are doing a Vaidika karma, which has got so many lopas in it, which can produce a papa, and it's an amalgamation of what? Punyam and papam, all the time. Therefore, whether it is manasam karma, or vachikam karma, or kayikam karma, physical action, mental action, oral action, all of them is an amalgamation. It is not good enough to get you out of samsara. Therefore, what? Anantaram cha antasopadikatma atmadarshanam uktam vyahrididvarena swarajya palam nacha yetavata asheshatah samsara bijasya upamardanam asti. So anantaram cha, thereafter, having gone through the first chapter, practiced meditations for a while, done these rituals for a while, accomplished purity of mind. What do you mean by purity of mind again? All these are words. So you hear a word, don't gloss over a word. If you gloss over a word, you will not understand the word. Then you say everything is Chitta Shuddhi. Purity of mind means freedom from likes and dislikes. From the hold of likes and dislikes. Freedom from raga dvesha. That is what Paramarthananji was telling today in the morning. Raga and dvesha. You've got likes as well as dislikes. From the hold of likes and dislikes. That means you do things what has got to be done. What is to be done, you like that. You go in tune with what is to be done. What is not to be done is avoided. That is what is the hold of raga and dvesha. You go by dharma. What is dharma, you have to see, and then you go. So dharma is also personal. It varies from individual to individual. There are certain samanya dharmas which are general, which is universal. But there are dharmas. Every dharma is what? Is dynamic. So what is good to you may not be good to the other person. What is good to him may not be good to you. It depends upon where you live, how you live, what is your lifestyle. Based upon that, it is dynamic. For it cannot, every dharma cannot be universal. So whatever you follow, you don't think the other person should also follow. You have to see what, from what condition, what background he is in. Based on that alone, we can, in fact, there are certain things which are universal which you need to follow. Like not cheating others. That's a universal value. So there are, samanya dharma is also there, vishesha dharmas are also there. Vishesha dharmas means what? Specific. Specific to a person, specific to an ashrama. By taking to the lifestyle of the samanya vishesha dharma, what happens in this person? He grows out of this likes and dislikes because he likes to sleep in the morning. 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, temple, Rudra Abhisheka, you have to get up and go. But what? It is a little bit cold, Swamiji. Nice to sleep in the Rajai. You know, we give Rajai. In the winter, there is a Rajai here. Now, this point of time is all kambals. Eh? They give you blankets. Rajai also is there? Okay. So, I don't have Rajai, that's why I'm asking you. So they give you this Rajai, you just go into it. After 5 minutes, it is all Swarga, correct? And then you do not want to get up. But what you have to do? You have to get up and go to the temple. So what is to be done is one thing. What you want to do is that another thing. There is a conflict between what is to be done and what you want to do. You have to come for meditation, you have to go to the temple. After all, it is Swamiji. Next year, be avo. Swamiji is going to be there. And the same meditation he is going to teach us. So this year I will sleep. You postpone. So that means you have taken your life for granted that you are going to be there next year. You have taken your admission for granted. You have taken my life also to be granted that I am going to be here next year. Understand? So what is to be done is one thing. What I like to do is yet another thing. When what is to be done is what I like to do, and what is not to be done is what I do not like to do. When that goes together, then you have accomplished Chitta Shuddhi. Until that, you have to get into this karma, be doing all these, you have to go to temple and all those things. That is called freedom from the hold of raga and the dvesha. Until then, all these are valid. Meditation is valid, karma is valid, everything is valid. But once you have accomplished this, tadanantaram. Vibhashikara is using the word anantaram. You have to observe that word anantaram. Not to drop karma because you are into the gates of Vedanta, understand? People have got this thinking. Hamto Bhagavad Gita, I am studying Gita. That means I am an adhikari. He has declared himself an adhikari. And then he has given up all the karmas. Tad anantaram. Anantaram means thereafter. Antasopadika atma darshanam uktam. There. Meditated on this Brahmatma was presented. Atma was presented with attributes. It is also a meditation. Very same Atma Brahman was loaded with certain vyakritis, it was loaded with certain Brahma. Brahman was Brahmatma, is in fact Nirgunam, understand. The Nirguna Atma is not easy to understand. So the teaching is like this. Every Upanishad starts delivering Atma in its purest form. For students, how does Mundaka start? Yatta dadresham agrahyam agotram avarnam achaksha shrotram tadapanipadam nityam vibhum sarvagatam susukshmam bhutayonim paripashyanti dhiraha. Correct? That is the start. How is Yamadharma Raja starting Kathopanishad? Om ityetat. Mandukya. Where is it? Nantav pragyaha na bhagish pragyaha. Taittirīya Upanishad. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma. Yo veda nihitam guhayam parame vyoman. When all these things are presented, it all looks nice, but I am not able to grasp it. Correct? When you say shrotrasya shrotram manaso manoyate, what is presented is nirgunam, nirguna atma is presented. But our mind is not able to see that fact. The Upanishad recognizes it. Because the Upanishad is taught by a teacher, correct? The teacher sees all the blinking faces. And then what does he do? Oho, I have understood your problem. Because what? Brahman is nirgunam. You are not able to get it. Therefore, get Brahman married. Problem is solved. Bring in Maya. Tasmadva yetasmad atmana akasha sambhutaha. Akashadvayuhu. Ho gaya abhi, Taittirīya. Un mundaka. After yatornana abhishrijate grinnate cha. Jagat karanam brahma means what? Maya has come. That is what is happening. In every Upanishad, if you see, the Upanishad actually starts with what? With nirgunam brahma. Our mind not being able to comprehend it, lights down. Brahman is married to Maya. And when Maya comes, you say, I understand something, it is nice now. Because you are able to understand, now there is an attribute, the mind can hold on to this attribute, and then you are able to go up. It validates your thinking for some time. All right, there is a srishti. Tasmadva yetasmad atmana akasha sambhutaha. Akashad vayu. It brings in akasha, vayu, agni, apa, prithvi. The whole creation is brought in. And then it is in order to present, the creation is non-separate from the creator. By saying creation is non-separate from the creator, it has dismissed the creation again. All that is there is only the creator. It removes the status of creator. அததான் முன்னாடி சொன்னம்பா, இட் இஸ் நிர்குணம் பிரம்ம. இது த ஹோல் டீச்சிங் இஸ் இன் ஃபேக்ட் ரிகன்சைல்டு இன் திஸ் மேனர். அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஹவு தி ஃப்ளோ ஆஃப் உபனிஷத் இஸ். இஃப் திஸ் இஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டுட், இஃப் திஸ் விஷன் இஸ் கெப்ட் இன் மைண்ட் அண்ட் யூ ரீட் த உபனிஷத், உபனிஷத் ஆர் நாட் அ கான்ஃப்ளிக்ட். அதர்வைஸ் சடன்லி இட் வேர் இஸ் இட் சத்தியம் ஞானம் அனந்தம் அண்ட் தென் வாட் தஸ்மாத் வா ஏ தஸ்மாத், ஹவு டிட் நிர்குணம் பிரம்ம பிகம் சகுணம் பிரம்ம? இட் டிட் நாட் பிகம் அப்பா, இட் இஸ் ஒன்லி ஃபார் த சேக் ஆஃப் டீச்சிங். In your mind, you are not able to get it, therefore I am getting it married. You understand? For marriage helps sometimes. It is a thing. So here he says, Sa upadika. So upadika here means what? Sa upadika. Atma darshanam uktam. Brahmatma with various attributes was presented. And having presented that, the result of that meditation was also presented. That is called Swarajya Phalam. Vyakriti Dwarena Swarajya Phalam Uktam. Four Vyakritis. Bhuhu, Bhuvaha, Suvaha, Mahaha. Upon these Vyakritis, which happens to be, there were the locus of meditation. Various things were loaded. You can load in Omkara also, Akara, Ukara, Makara. Upon this Akara, Ukara, Makara, you load various things. Waker, dreamer, sleeper, waking state, dream state, sleep state. And then you perform meditations. That was all presented. And all the results given for the meditation are all within samsara. Understand? The phalam, the swarajya phalam that was pointed out, that's what Bhashyakara wants to say. That phala, the result or the benefit of that swarajya phalam, the sovereign status, given as a result of this meditation, is also what? Is also within samsara only. And therefore, nacha yetavata asheshataha samsara bijasya upamardhanam asti. The upamardhana means the destruction or the elimination of samsara bija. The cause of samsara, whatever happens to be the cause of samsara, the elimination of the cause of samsara does not take place totally. Because I am the doer, the sense of doership being there. Whenever you do an action, you entertain the sense of doership. As long as the sense of doership is there, samsara is there. Because you say what? I did it. This is my action. You did it, right? The result also belongs to you. Punya is also yours. Papa is also yours. When Punya Papa is mine, then Janma, birth and death also happens to this body. Because you claim it. Right? All karta. This kartrutvam. Like this, terrorists are all claiming, you know, after the bomb blast, I only did it. Like this, we also are. There is a terrorist inside. Everybody is a terrorist, understand? The karta is a terrorist here. He comes out and claims, I did it. This is mine. That ahankara mamakara bhava makes you acquire the result of an action, which is in the form of what? Punya and papa. Therefore what? The destruction or elimination of samsara bija, the cause of samsara, does not take place asheshatah. Totally it does not take place. It doesn't go away at all. Karma yoga, can it destroy it? Swamiji, I am doing karma yoga. I am not doing karma. I am doing karma yoga. Ishwara Arpana, Ishwara Prasada Buddhi is Karma Yoga. Swamiji talked about it last evening, I suppose. That also is not going to eliminate. Why? Because you may be a karma yogi. A karma yogi is like traveling on a Mercedes Benz or a BMW where you don't feel the pain of shock. The shock absorbers are very powerful. You can, if you are on an Indian road with speed breakers and all those things, it doesn't kick your back. Other cars, your back is gone. Correct? Especially on Indian roads. The bumps will take you off. But karma yoga is like a shock absorber which can absorb the shock to a certain extent. It cannot totally eliminate samsara, but it makes you travel smoothly. The attitude. Why it cannot totally eliminate? Because you will claim yourself as what? I am a karma yogi. This is another problem. Earlier the fellow was claiming the karma. I did this. The karma yogi does not say, I did it. The karma yogi says what? I did not do it. I am a karma yogi. Malum ho gaya? The ego has survived again. Correct? The ego is now resolved from karma. The ego is now holding on to what? The renouncer of that karma, it holds on to that renunciation. That is called karma. That's why sannyasa is not external. The renouncer has got to be renounced. It's the most difficult thing to do. The renouncer has got to go. The one who renounces, he has to be renounced first. The karma yogi holds on to that. He is a mumukshu, no doubt he is a mumukshu, he is interested in moksha, he is definitely better than the other fellow. But still a samsari. Still a samsari. So, Bhashyakara says here, upamardhanam, upamardhanam means elimination of samsara bija does not have, samsara bija means what? The cause of samsara that does not take place totally. Etavata, by the practice of whatever that has been said so far, it does not eliminate your samsara totally. Tamil people are here. Samsara, you have to understand, it is not wife. Tamil people, Tamilians should be careful with some Sanskrit words. I am a Tamilian, therefore I know where the problem is. So in Tamil, samsara means wife. Understand? So elimination of samsara means what? Elimination of wife. So this is a thing, I didn't tell Paramarthananda ji, but I can tell him. So when I started going to his class, my mother introduced me to Swamiji. And I was very young. First time I heard the word samsara and all those things, I didn't understand the meaning of the word samsara. That day, a lot of samsara was used. You should eliminate samsara. Swamiji has already built a crowd like that. I am just a newcomer, came in between, you know. Already on a running bus, I have just got into it. So, I just came there and one or two words, samsara. I said, okay, elimination of samsara. I didn't understand what is samsara. My father did not want my mother to go to the class. And I was wondering, why does he do it? And I thought, probably Swamiji says elimination of samsara, elimination of wife, this is his problem. Understand? So samsara, you should be careful. It's not wife here. It is the seeking, that attitude that you have got with you, that I am a wanting person. The sense of limitation in you is samsara. That sense of limitation does not go away completely. Therefore what? Therefore, ataha, in order to remove that totally, the second chapter is being started. See how he connects it. So the second chapter, for the purpose of elimination of ignorance, which happens to be the cause of all the problems without an exception. the second chapter is started. Atah Asheshah
Upadrava Bijasya
Ajnanasya Nivrityartam Viduta Sarva Upa Sarva Upadi Vishesha Vishesha. Okay. Viduta Sarva Upadi Visheshatma Darshanartham. Visheshatma Darshanartham. Idam Arabhyate. Brahma Vidapnoti Param Ityadi. Ataha. Thereafter. Therefore. Ashesha upadrava bijasya ajnanasya nivrityartham. For the elimination of ignorance, which happens to be the cause of all upadravas. Upadrava means whatever that irritates you. Anything that you don't like is upadrava. Like sorrow, pain. All of them. Therefore, for the elimination of ignorance. So, if you want to eliminate sorrow, why should you eliminate ignorance, Swamiji? What is the connection? If you are not clear with this connection, that is called a sambandha. If you are not clear with this connection between ignorance and elimination of sorrow, you will end up in Kundalini Yoga. Understand? Because they also claim yoga ha chitta vritti nirodha. They also say the problem is the mind. Correct? The problem is to the mind. The one who feels the problem is the mind. Mind is in the form of a thought. Therefore, what now? Don't have any thoughts. You will have. It's like, you know, I got into marriage and then you started having all the problems. Now what? After I got married, I had all these problems. Therefore, what is the cause of all the problems? Marriage. So what should I do? Get out of marriage. Like that, Patanjali also advises. He doesn't advise like that. People who read Patanjali's Yoga Sutra interpret in this manner. Mind is the problem, take it out. This is the thinking. Chitta vritti nirodha. Nirodha here means what? Cessation of thoughts. May you not have any thought. Therefore, you are working for what? Thoughtlessness. A thoughtlessness is another thought. Correct? That is also a thought. What are you going to do? It's absence of thought, they say. It's not absence of thought. It is another thought. In sleep, nidra is a thought. Understand? Nidra vritti, we say. It's called nidra vritti. Ati sukshmagara vritti and all those things we say. For everything is in fact a thought. So getting out of thought is not going to solve the problem here. Therefore here he says, elimination of ignorance which happens to be the cause of all the sufferings. They are connected. Ignorance and suffering, ignorance and sorrow are connected. Whenever avidya is used, understand ignorance about not physics, ignorance of my own self. Because I have misunderstood myself, I have taken myself to be something else other than what I am. I don't know who I am. Therefore, what did I say? My name is so and so. That is not you, correct? I belong to this person. I come from this country. All these are introductions about your body, about your mind, about your ahankara. But who are you? Not known. You don't know it. And since I don't know, what did I do? I comfortably made a superimposition. Understand that you know something about yourself, you do not know some other part of yourself. You know that you exist. There is no confusion. That I exist is known to me. As what I exist is not known to me, therefore there is a confusion in how I exist, as what I exist. You have done. What is this gentleman? You have done. You're done with Swamiji? And first, what is the name? I think he's sitting here. Tim. Yeah, you're done? Yeah. Have you done?
Yes.
Yeah. I was looking for you only. So as what I exist is not known. Therefore, what do? You happily conclude. Whatever is very, very closely and intimately associated with me, I have concluded that as me, myself. This we do all the time. Correct? We do all the time. Whatever is very closely associated, that becomes yours. Like the other house, the gentleman put a flower in the boundary wall. Okay? And you went and watered it. 1 or 2 days and took some flowers. Every day you are taking from flowers. After 3 years you ask, these are all my plants, this fellow says. It's become his. That is how people occupy places in Rishikesh. All our lands have been occupied and I have to fight 25 cases in the court. So you need a Swami here to take care of all these things. The older you become, you can be cheated because you cannot go out of the ashram. You see, so whatever is happening outside, we don't know, you occupy the lands. And after 10 years, you claim, I am living here, it is my place. You do this in your life, this is called adhyasa. You transfer somebody's properties onto yourself. The body is not you, the mind is not you. You have happily and comfortably owned up this body, mind is you yourself. This is called adhyasa. That adhyasa takes place. Then because of adhyasa, what happens? The moment I have owned it up, I get deeply attached to this body. Now I have to keep the body going. Therefore what? Go to treadmill. Break your knees. All these things happen. Desire is born. You have to fulfill the desire, karma. Karma again, punya. Punya and papa, samsara. Therefore, these two are connected. Samsara here, when you say, Bhashikara is talking about dukkha nivritti. Then you are born and gone. In between this birth and death, what is there and now? Shoka is also there, correct? Sukhi yavaro. How much of sukha you experience? Thoda soda. Dukki. Abdi nirukkano. Then it becomes la. Dukkha is more in life than sukhi. Correct? Sukha is less. Dukki. We go to this Griha Pravesas, you know, when they call me to Griha Pravesa. These people are very proud in showing the house in a Griha Pravesa. In India, in Bombay, I went. He was just going around the house and showing, Swamiji, this is my new house. And there are a few people also with me. This is my hall, this is my, you know, I planned it this way and this is my wife's idea. All those things have been presented. When you go to a Griha Pravesa, you just enjoy and enjoy, listen to the other person, then bless it and come back. The other fellow asked him a question. He is already enjoying this house now. While he is enjoying the house, he asked, how much is your debt? How much loan did you take? Gone. The moment you think about the loan in order to buy the house, your enjoyment is gone now completely, correct? That is called dukkha. Understand? Sukha and dukkha. Both of them
is inevitable, it cannot be avoided.
Therefore, dukkha is a part and parcel of this birth and death. It comes in between, you cannot avoid it.
In order to eliminate that dukkha, karma cannot do it.
Because karma propagates it. It is within the cycle, understand? You need to have something which is out of the box. You know, you say out of box thinking. You need to have something which is opposed to this karma called jnanam.
So, ajnanasya nivrityartam, for the purpose of elimination of this ignorance, which happens to be the cause of all these upadravas, the sorrows, this chapter is being started. For that purpose, in order to remove the ignorance, viduta sarva upadi vishesha atma darshanam idam uchyate. This self-knowledge is being taught for that purpose. Viduta sarva upadi vishesha atma. Vidutani sarva upadi visheshani yasya atmanah saha.
If you don't understand, it is fine. People will understand. So, the self that is free from all the attributes born of various upadis. That means, this Atma does not have any attribute or anything of its own. Atma is what? It is all the time Satchit Ananda. The sense of limitation that you have does not belong to Atma. The apurnatvam that you have does not belong to you really. The sorrows that you undergo, the pain that you undergo does not belong to you. It belongs to what? It belongs to something other than Atma, which is called Upadi, which is in close proximity with this Atma, doesn't belong to Atma in any way. Like you have a crystal. And you see that the crystal is red in color. Is there anything called red crystal? Huh? I don't know, in America they may have, I don't know. Is there anything called red crystal? The redness has got to be transferred from something else, correct? Then you call it as red crystal. It doesn't belong to the crystal anymore. Everything is like this. Where is the pot? There is no pot kept here. Okay. Iron, hot iron ball. Heat doesn't belong to the ball. Roundness does not belong to iron there, but you transfer it, correct? What makes you transfer it? How do you transfer it? There is some reason for you to transfer it. There is something else which is in fact having that attribute, which is very close, which is in proximity with this object, like the crystal and the redness.